Good morning, students. So in our integral part from the exercise 7.1, some questions we have done. So now today we have to discuss three questions, and these three questions are, if you see here, the questions are 13, 14 and 15. So mainly these three questions we have to do here. And now in these three questions, so if you see the first one, the first question is given here, integration x cube minus x square plus x minus 1 divided by x minus 1 dx. So that means this one is a question here, and what you have to do, we have to integrate this result. So now this question, how can we solve? Let's see here. So first of all, what you have to do, so if you see the question, so first of all we have to consider the integration. Let i equals to we have to write this one is x cube minus x square plus x minus 1 divided by x minus of 1 dx. So this one we have to write first. So now after that, what you have to do, if you see the numerator part, so here in two ways we can do this one. So first of all, very simple process is what here, if you see this two, x cube minus x square, if you see here x cube minus x square, what is common? X is common. So if you take x common from the first part, so here the denominator remains same, x minus 1. So if you take x common, then this one x square common. If you take x square common, then this one remain x minus 1 and plus of 1. So if you take 1 common, then here this one is remain x minus 1 into dx. Is it clear? So now from here, what will common here? So this one is x minus 1. So here x minus 1 is common. So if you take x minus 1 common, then this one remain here x square plus 1 into dx. Is it clear? So this one remain. So now here we take x minus 1 common, and then here remain x square, and then here remain plus 1. So x minus 1 here cancel, isn't it? So if we cancel these two, then simply here remain this one is x square plus of 1 into dx. You see here. Ultimately this one remain here x square plus 1 into dx. So if you integrate this one, so easily we can separate into two parts. So this one we have to separate, and then we write here x square dx plus, and this one is 1 into dx. You see here, if you separate the result here, so integration x square dx plus 1 into dx we get, isn't it? So now after that, if you integrate this one, now here which formula we have to apply? So it is of the form x to the power n dx. So if you see the formula here first, if you see the formula integration, so integration x to the power n dx, so the formula we know, this one is the formula here, integration x to the power n dx, means we have to write this one is x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus of c, where c is an integrating constant. One formula we have to apply this one here. Is it clear? So another formula here, 1 dx, that means simply integration dx. So another formula we have to apply here, and this one is integration dx. So integration dx means what? X plus of c. Mainly these two formulas we have to use here. Is it clear? These two formula we have to use. So after this step, now after this step, the next step is, if I write here, if you see here, so this one equals to, after this step, if we write integration x square dx, that means n means what here? 2. That means what you have to write? 2 plus 1. So that's why we have to write here x to the power 2 plus 1 divided by 2 plus of 1 plus of c. Isn't it? So one thing you see here, one integrating constant we get here, another integrating constant we get here. The sum of two constant is again a constant term. So that's why no need to write separately, as a whole we write. So x square dx plus integration dx means what you have to write? We have to write x, and the sum of two integrating constant is again a constant. So that's why simply we have to write here c. Is it clear? And here we have to write finally the answer is x cube by 3 plus of x plus of c, where under this you have to write where c is an integrating constant. Is it clear? Very simple question. So in this way we can solve this question number 13. So one more method is there to solve this. What you have to do, this numerator part we have to divide it by this denominator. This one is here dividend divisor. So if you divide, then with the help of this method also we can solve this type of questions. Is it clear? I think all of you understood this one now, isn't it? So now here, after completing this one, now we have to do the next one. So in the next question, the question number 14. So if you see the question here, the question number 14 is this one. So all of you see here the question number 14, and in this question number 14 the question is given integration 1 minus x into root x dx. So the question is here given this one. So first of all, what you have to do, first of all, if we consider, let I equals to integration 1 minus of x, this one we have to write root x dx. So here, how can we integrate this result? First of all, you see, these two are given in multiplication form, isn't it? So now here, we have to separate, we have to convert this one into a general polynomial form. So that's why we have to multiply these two first. So that's why what you have to write here, you see, x to the power root x. So root x means also we can write x to the power half, isn't it? So root x, means we can write x to the power half. So that's why here, if we multiply these two, then what we get? 1 into x to the power half. That means we have to write here x to the power half. Is it clear? And minus. Now, if you see here, here it is x, here it is x to the power half. So what you have to write here? Let's see. X into x to the power half. Root x means x to the power half. We have to multiply these two. So that means here the base is same. So what you have to do? We add the powers. So that means here the power of x is 1, here 1 by 2. So simply we have to write x 1 plus 1 by 2. Ultimately the answer what we get here? 2 plus 1, 3. So 3 by 2. So that means this result is what? X to the power 3 by 2. So if you multiply these two, then we get here x to the power 3 by 2. And this one is into dx. Now if we separate this result, so we write here x to the power 1 by 2 dx minus this one you have to write x to the power 3 by 2 dx. Is it clear? So this one you have to write. Now here, which formula we have to apply here? Again, it is of the form x to the power n dx, isn't it? So we have to apply this formula, and then what we have to write? We have to write here x to the power 1 by 2 plus of 1. Here 1 by 2 plus of 1. Plus of, in the second part, again we have to apply the x, this one is minus, minus of. So here x to the power 3 by 2, that means again it is of the form x to the power n. So that's what you have to write here. In this case we have to write x to the power 3 by 2, 3 by 2 plus of 1, 3 by 2 plus of 1, plus of c, where c is an integrating constant. Is it clear? So if we calculate this result, then easily we can write down the answer here. So x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1. So what you have to write here? So this one we have to write x to the power 3 by 2. So this one is we have to write 3 by 2. Is it clear? Similarly here minus, this one you have to write x to the power 3 by 2 plus 1. That means how much you have to write? Obviously 5 by 2. So that's why x to the power 5 by 2. This one is we have to write 5 by 2 plus of c, where c is an integrating constant. Is it clear? So this one is the solution of second question, which one is question number 14. Is it clear? So I think all of you understood this one. Next one is, now here, after completing the question number 14, now the next question is, if you see the question is given like in this way here, if you see the question, and the question is given here, integration root x in bracket here given 3x square plus twice x plus 3 into dx, isn't it? So this one is the question given here. So if you see the question, so the same pattern whatever we have done in question number 14, the same thing we have to do here in this question. So what you have to do? We have to multiply this root x with this all these three terms, then easily we can calculate the answer here. So for that reason here, what you have to do, just you have to write, let I equals to integration root x. So integration root x, and then we have to write this one is 3x square plus twice x plus 3 into dx. So this one is the question, root x 3x square plus twice x plus 3. So in this case, now here what you have to do, if we multiply this result, I write directly here x to the power root x means what? X to the power half. So x to the power half and x square, if you add these two, if you see here x to the power half, this one is x to the power half into x square. What we get? X to the power 1 by 2 plus 2. That means ultimately how much we get here? X to the power 2 to the 4, 5 by 2. Isn't it? This one we get here. 2 to the 4, 4 plus 1, 5. 5 by 2. So that means here in the first case we get here 3 x to the power 5 by 2. Is it clear? Plus second one. So if you multiply the second one, how much we get here? 2x to the power 1 plus 1 by 2. That means this one we get here 3 by 2 plus, and the last one is constant term. So simply we write here 3 to the power 1 by 2 into dx. Is it clear? So we get this result. So now here, if we separate here, now in case of integration, this 3, 2 and 3, these are what? Constant term. So we can take this one outside of this integration. So simply we have to write 3, this one you have to write x to the power 5 by 2 dx if you separate. Plus the second one is 2 constant term, integration of x to the power 3 by 2 dx. Is it clear? Plus, and the last one is 3 is the constant term, 3 integration of x to the power 1 by 2 dx. Is it clear? So if you separate, then easily we can write like in this way. Now after that, all of you know what you have to do. If you see, each and every part is of the form x to the power n dx, isn't it? So x to the power n dx, integration x to the power n dx means the formula is what? X to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So that's why here what you have to write, this one you have to write 3 and x to the power 5 by 2 plus of 1, 5 by 2 plus of 1. Is it clear? Plus of. Then the second one is 2 is already there. So this one you have to write x to the power 3 by 2 plus of 1. This one is you have to write 3 by 2 plus of 1. Is it clear? And finally the last one is here 3. Already here. So x to the power 1 by 2 means we have to write 1 by 2 plus of 1, 1 by 2 plus of 1. Plus of c, where c is an integrating constant. So here we get one constant, another one, another one. So three constants how we get here. So as a whole, in general, we have to write one constant. Which one is here? C. Is it clear? I think all of you understood this one. So now finally, we have to calculate this result. So if we calculate this result, then what we get? Let's see here, 5 by 2 plus 1. That means 7 by 2. So that means we have to write this one is x to the power 7 by 2, 7 by 2 plus of. Now here what we get? 2 is already here. Then what you have to write? 3 by 2 plus 1. That means 5 by 2, 5 by 2. So that's why we have to write this one is x to the power 5 by 2. This one you have to write 5 by 2. Is it clear? And finally the last one is plus 3. And here what you have to write? 1 by 2 plus 1. That means 3 by 2. So that's why we have to write here x to the power 3 by 2, 3 by 2 plus of c, where c is an integrating constant. I think all of you understood. So in this way, very easily we can solve this exercise 7.1. So I think all of you understood this these three questions. So your task is what? You have to continue this exercise and you have to complete this exercise. Or if any questions or any doubts are still there, then you can ask me. So in our next class, we have to start our next topic, which one is the substitution method. So in integration, mainly there are three methods are there: substitution, then integration by parts, and the partial fraction. So these three are main part here in case of integration or integrals. So now in our next class, we have to discuss this. So your first task is you have to complete this exercise 7.1. Is it clear? Okay, thank you.